The sanctified life, the golden image, light direct from heaven, had been permitted to shine upon King Nebuchadnezzar, and for a little time he was influenced by the fear of God. But a few years of prosperity filled his heart with pride, and he forgot his acknowledgement of the living God. He resumed his idol worship with increased zeal and bigotry. From the treasures obtained in war, he made a golden image to represent the one that he had seen in his dream, setting it up in the plain of Dura and commanding all the rulers and the people to worship it on pain of death. This statue was about 90 feet in height and 9 in breadth, and in the eyes of that idolatrous people, it presented a most imposing and majestic appearance. A proclamation was issued calling upon all the officers of the kingdom to assemble at the dedication of the image and at the sound of the musical instruments to bow down and worship it. Should any fail to do this, they were immediately to be cast into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. The appointed day has come, and the vast company is assembled, when word is brought to the king that the three Hebrews whom he has set over the province of Babylon have refused to worship the image. These are Daniel's three companions who had been called by the king, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Full of rage, the monarch calls them before him, and pointing to the angry furnace, tells them the punishment that will be theirs if they refuse obedience to his will. In vain were the king's threats. He could not turn these noble men from their allegiance to the great ruler of nations. They had learned from the history of their fathers that disobedience to God is dishonor, disaster, and ruin, that the fear of the Lord is not only the beginning of wisdom, but the foundation of all true prosperity. They look with calmness upon the fiery furnace and the idolatrous throng. They have trusted in God, and He will not fail them now. Their answer is respectful but decided. Be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Daniel 3, verse 18. The proud monarch is surrounded by his great men, the officers of the government, and the army that has conquered nations, and all unite in applauding him as having the wisdom and power of the gods. In the midst of this imposing display stand the three youthful Hebrews, steadily persisting in their refusal to obey the king's decree. They had been obedient to the laws of Babylon, so far as these did not conflict with the claims of God, but they would not be swayed a hair's breadth from the duty they owed to their Creator. The king's wrath knew no limits. In the very height of his power and glory, to be thus defied by the representatives of a despised and captive race was an insult which his proud spirit could not endure. The fiery furnace had been heated 7 times more than it was wont, and into it were cast the Hebrew exiles. So furious were the flames that the men who cast them in were burned to death. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 4, The Fiery Furnace.